My name is Vicki Hodge. I'm principal at Baxter Elementary. I'm here to talk a little bit about social-emotional learning today.
I'm Lou Pondolfino, the principal at the King Career Center, and I wanted to talk a little bit about how SEL applies to high school students, and particularly at a career and technical education facility like ours.
My name is Pamela Orm. I'm the Social Studies Curriculum Coordinator at the Anchorage School District.
Social-emotional learning is caring about the whole child. In order to really teach students about social-emotional learning, in the Anchorage School District, we have 15 standards that address, that really help us to be able to teach students about how to manage their emotions, how to be self-aware, and then how to interact in a positive way with others and within their community. And so really, social-emotional learning really is, it's teaching students how to be self-aware, how to manage their own emotions, how to meet their social and emotional needs. And then when we've done that, we have happy learners. We have students that can focus on academics because they're not sidetracked with a lot of other issues. And in because of that, our test scores are higher. We have noticed a definite difference in our academic achievement. We have less office referrals. We have a positive school climate where students treat each other respectfully. And it's interesting because of having done this program and, or this method of teaching for now 7 years in this building, how our students that have been here, when we have new students come in, they train them, they teach them the matrix, they teach them the expectations. And so because of that, we can get students within, become a part of our school climate, and they just meld in and they are successful. And so social emotional learning is making a difference for the students at Baxter.
In the spring, the Anchorage School District adopted the Common Core State Standards. The Common Core added a new dimension to our standards with the goal to produce 21st century skills and prepare students for success in their lives. We are no longer being guided by just reading and writing standards. There's a complexity of social and emotional skills that need to be taught. As we started to unpack these new standards, we found a clear correlation between the Common Core and social and emotional learning. We've just produced a new second grade reader for social studies. It focuses on the city of Anchorage. In the process of unpacking this new Common Core standard, our teachers found a naturally strong correlation between the Common Core and social and emotional learning. We have highlighted this connection in the lessons that support this reader. Through our alignment, we have learned from our teachers the benefit of the building block support that social and emotional learning provides and how together they produce strong outcomes in the classroom. We recognize that components of social and emotional learning provide a clear foundation for students to successfully achieve the Common Core standards. Let's look quickly at one second grade example. Common Core Writing 2.3. It states, the student will write narratives in which they recount a well-elaborated event or short sequence of events, include details to describe actions, thoughts, and feelings, use temporal words to signal event order, and provide a sense of closure. Now let's look at social-emotional learning, self-awareness, I am. Students demonstrate awareness of their emotions, recognize and label emotions and feelings, describe their emotions and the situations that cause them. It's clear these directly support students' ability to complete this writing task. It also guides the teachers in terms of class discussions. These natural correlations between Common Core standards help guide teachers through step-by-step implementation and will afford our students a strong foundation of social and emotional skills that will support their growth and development for success in life.
We focus on face-to-face communication skills, working with people and for people, and I think that high school students interact best with each other and with their teachers and with industry when they have that real-life experience. So our students get off campus, they go into jobs and careers and practice those skills. And I think it's all tied into social-emotional learning. How to relate to people and how to present yourself in a way that's effective, and it's what employers want. And we focus our attention on nurturing those skills with young people. The K-12 focus in the Anchorage School District on SEL is important. In high school, we see it as the culminating step for preparing students for business and industry and careers in post-secondary education. We realize the importance of SEL. We know that employers insist on employees having those skills. We know students will be more successful in post-secondary endeavors, both technical schools, colleges, or directly into the workforce, if they have strong SEL skills. So we'll continue to focus on building those skills in our students. We believe students are better adjusted and more engaged in their academics and in school in general if they have strong social-emotional learning skills. Sometimes we think that academic achievement precedes those skills, and sometimes those skills precede academic achievement, but they go hand in hand. And if we have a well-rounded student, we know that their chances of success academically go up substantially.